My dear students, myself Suguna HG, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, JFGC and PG Center, Chintamani, Chikkaballapur District. In this video, I am going to state and prove the Gauss Divergence Theorem. The Gauss Divergence Theorem is an important result for the mathematics of physics and engineering, particularly in electronics and fluid dynamics. The divergence theorem states that the surface integral of a vector over a closed surface, which is called the flux through the surface, is equal to the volume of integral of the divergence over the region inside the surface. Gauss divergence theorem statement: if f is a continuous differentiable vector point function and V is the volume bounded by the closed surface S, then double integral over the surface S of f dot n ds is equal to triple integral over the volume V of divergence f dv, where n cap is the outward unit normal vector. Proof: let the vector f is equal to f1i plus f2j plus f3k, and divergence f is equal to dou f1 by x plus dou f2 by y plus dou f3 by z. To prove that the surface integral of f1i plus f2j plus f3k dot n ds is equal to volume integral of dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z into dv, let us consider a diagram where S is a closed surface such that a line drawn parallel to the coordinate axis cuts S not more than two points. Let the equation of the lower and upper portion S1 and S2 of the surface S be denote Z is equal to F1XY and Z is equal to F2XY respectively. See, we have considered a surface S such that any line drawn parallel to the any coordinate axis which cuts at not more than two points, let those lower and upper portions as S1 and S2 of the surface S, and let us denote them by Z is equal to F1Y for S1 portion, and S2 portion Z is equal to F2XY. See, these are the two portions. The lower portion is S1, upper portion is S2. Let the projection of this S on the XY plane be R. See, R is the projection of the S in the XY plane. Then we have the triple integral over the volume V of dou F3 by dou Z into dV is equal to triple integral over V of dou F3 by dou Z, and dV is replaced by dz dx dy. And this triple integral is converted as the double integral over the region R of F3 of x comma y comma z2 minus F3 of x comma y comma z1 dx dy, because dou F3 by dou Z, and we have simplified with respect to Z. So, we get F3 of x comma y comma z2 minus F3 of x comma y comma z1 dx dy. Then, this is F3 of x comma y comma z2 into dx dy minus double integral over the region R of F3 of x comma y comma z1 into dx dy. We have split this integral into two parts. Take this as equation 1. Let S1 and S2 be lower and upper portions of the surface corresponding to P1, P2 respectively. Let N1 be the outward normal drawn to the outward unit normal at P2 and S2, and making an acute angle R2 with K, then dx dy is equal to R cos 2 ds 2. See, N2 is the outward normal drawn to the surface S2, and similarly N1 is the outward normal drawn to the S1 surface. So we get dx dy is equal to cos r2 ds2, and dx dy is nothing but r cos 2 is k dot n2, because the projection is taken in the xy plane. And let n1 be the outward unit normal drawn at p1 to s1, making an acute angle r1 with k. Then dx dy is equal to r cos r1 ds1, that is nothing but k dot n. So dx dy is equal to k dot n1 ds1. Equation 1 becomes triple integral over the volume V of dou f3 by dou z into dv becomes surface integral, that is a double integral at S2, f3 k dot n2 ds2, and surface integral over S1 surface f3 k dot n1 ds. So now by taking these two results, we get it as the triple integral of dou f3 by dou z into dv is equal to double integral over the surface S of f3 k dot n ds. So S1 and S2 surfaces. Then similarly, if you take the projection of S on yz plane and zx plane, we get the triple integral over the volume V of dou f1, see along the yz plane, dou f1 by dou x into dv is equal to the double integral over the surface S of f1 I dot n ds. Take this as equation 3. Then similarly, along with the zx plane, triple integral over the volume V of dou f2 by dou y, because zx plane is perpendicular to y. So dou f2 by dou y into dv is equal to double integral over the surface S of f2 j dot n cap ds. Take this as equation 4. Now by adding all these three equations, equation 2, equation 3 and equation 4, we get double integral over the surface S of, add all the f1, f2, f3s. So you will get f1i plus f2j plus f3k dot n ds is equal to triple integral over the volume V of dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z. See, f1i plus f2j plus f3k is nothing but vector f. So we get double integral over the surface S of f dot n ds is equal to triple integral over the volume V of divergence f dv. See, dou f1 by dou x plus dou f2 by dou y plus dou f3 by dou z is nothing but divergence f. Hence, the surface integral f dot n ds is converted into volume integral of divergence of f dv. Hence, theorem is proved. Thank you.